In this video, I'm going to take you through how to access KenyaMAR data tools. Log in to your desktop application, Ubuntu. Once you log in from your Ubuntu desktop, there's an icon written KenyaMAR data tools. To launch KenyaMAR data tools, double click on the icon KenyaMAR data tools. It will open the KenyaMAR data tools, clearly written on top there, KenyaMAR data tools version 1.01. As you can see, you don't require login credentials to open up KenyaMAR data tools. This has already been provided for by default. So let's describe the KenyaMAR data tools. At the top, we have some buttons and icon. The first two buttons are the back and the next button. We have the following icons. We have the metadata explorer icon, the command editor button, the query design icon. In this session, we'll focus our attention in the query design button. Apart from that also, we have the preferences icon, we have the new driver icon, we have the new data source icon, and lastly, we have the delete selection icon. As I told you earlier, our main focus will be on the query designer icon. It's important to note that KenyaMAR data tools is linked to the KenyaMAR database, highlighted here. Once you expand, you're able to see the tables that are contained in the database. That is good to know. So let's get back and start off. As I'd mentioned earlier, that our focus will be on Query Designer. Click on the Query Designer icon to reveal the query page. This query page has got two panels, navigation panels on the left, the top one and the bottom one. We'll focus our attention on the bottom table, which has got all these data elements contained in tables. Then we also have a working area. To launch a table onto the working area, double click on your data element of interest. I'll pick on the patient demographics, double click. It will end up on our work area. To visualize a report in this table, there are data elements contained in the table, and this is the arrangement in KenyaMAR database. So if you want to visualize a report contained in this table, click on the checkbox of your interest. I'm interested to see the name of the patient, or the three names, the gender of the patient, their date of birth, their unique number in the report. I'm also interested to see their phone number, marital status, and education level. Once you are done itemizing your data elements of interest, click on the launch query icon in green, and your report will be populated below. Notice the report is arranged according to how you selected the sequence of how you selected your data elements of interest. Also remember, this report can be exported to Excel, and you can still have the same report exported to Pivot for further analysis within the same browser. We also have a filter to filter information contained in this report of ours. To filter your report, click on the filter icon. For ease of visualization, expand the filter page by clicking on the maximize icon. Click on the add button, then the drop-down menu will arrange all the data elements. Select the data element you want to be used to filter your report. So I want us to filter our report by date of birth. I'll select date of birth. Select your filter parameters. For example, we have equal to, less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, range, not equal to, like, not like, is not, in, and lastly, not in. So for our case here, we're going to pick a range. Once you itemize your filter parameter, you'll go now to the field to type the exact range you are interested in. So I'm interested within a range of 15, separated with a dash to 50. Then I'll come and click the OK button to display my report. And there is my report. So filters will enable you to filter reports based on your filter parameters and the characteristics you like appear in your report. Let me show you now how to export this to Excel. Click on the Excel icon to export. It will tell you to choose where you want it exported to. Give it a name. We can say demo data, demographic data. It will open up your report in Excel. So here is your Excel report. So basically you can come pick it using your flash drive and pick it for further analysis from there. Remember, KenyaMart Data Tools allows you to combine more than one table. Let us now combine tables. Let's get back now to our tables query panel. From the tables panel, select your tables of interest. I'll choose on patient demographics and HIV follow-up table. So we have the two tables that are combined with what is identical in both the two tables, which is patient ID. Click on the icon between the connection of the two to actually authenticate that communication. Select your data elements of choice from the first table. Then proceed to the second table and select your data elements of choice too. Once done, click on your launch query icon to visualize your reports. There appears your reports. As I pointed to earlier, this report can still be exported to Excel, to pivot tables, and you can still filter the same report within the same instance. But let me now focus our attention to pivoting of the reports. We'll click on the pivot icon, still loading, confirming to you that the pivot table is loading. Kindly note, pivot tables runs within a browser. Let me now briefly describe how to manipulate and mine out data from the pivot tables. We have our first column with the table selected by default. You can visualize your data either using a table bar chart, heat map, row heat map, line chart, bar charts, and others. In the next column, select how you want your data analyzed. By default, we have counts, but you can still use other analytical parameters displayed, sum, average, among others. Let's get back to our data exported to our pivot table. We have a total of 32,271 records. Remember, to pick your data element of interest, you'll have to come pick it, drag to where you want it displayed. We have the columns and the rows. If you want your data element to appear on the column, click and pick it, drag to the column window. So basically, you will have your data appearing in column. So let us interpret a little bit of this data here. Remember, the database captures the number of encounters. It doesn't mean that we have 34 Abigails in the database. What this means is that Abigail has been seen 34 times. Let's move this further to analyze the name of the patient versus the WHO stage during every visit. We'll come and pick on WHO stage, drag it to the row. So basically, it will give you a summary. We have the null column here. It means that during these four visits, Abigail's WHO stage was not captured in the EMR. The second row, it means that during the 25 visits, Abigail was recorded as being in stage 1. Four times, she was recorded as being in stage 2. Once, she was recorded in being stage 3. But Abigail has never been staged at stage 4 in all the appearances during her visit. So basically, pivot tables enables you to pick up data elements in comparison and get a summary of how you want these presented to you. Let us now pick another data element for comparison. I will return back the WHO stage by dragging it back to the column. I will pick CTX adherence. Let's do a comparison on CTX adherence during every visit. Drag it to the row. Let's stick to Abigail. Notice that in the total 34 visits Abigail made to the facility, 32 visits, the adherence was recorded as good, whereas the 2 visits, there was no adherence recorded. So they are actually in the null column. This is a null column. So it gives you a summary of the adherence of the patients in every visit as captured in the database. You can still do that even for the TB status. Click and drag to the row. It will give you a summary. In the 34 visits made, during the 32 visits, Abigail had no signs for TB, while in the 2 visits, it was actually null, meaning that the ICF TB screening was skipped during the 2 visits. So we can still do further analysis. We can pick on the nutritional status. You can pick, drag, drop in the row, and it will be given a summary of the nutritional status. As you can notice, A lot of patients are not being screened for nutritional status. CTX, come and pick on CTX. CTX dispense. You get a summary of CTX dispense. Then this data can still be visualized using a bar chart. Sorry, I've selected heat maps. Basically the extremes, heat maps. You pick the extremes values. Bar charts, not make a lot of sense because of the huge numbers. So actually pick on what will make a lot of sense, analytical sense. Keep in mind that the basic principles of statistics apply. Choose a method of data presentation suitable to your dataset. For instance, if you want a bar graph from the output here, select bar charts. Basically, this does not make sense. This is very condensed for the dataset chosen. So, all the basic principles of statistics apply. This marks the end of our KenyaMR Data Tools session. Thank you.